Hello, welcome to the fantastic demo experiment of Bernoulli principle. The air going here is at high speed and the air going in the direction is low speed. So Bernoulli made one postulate, assumption, that where there is high speed, there is less pressure, and where there is less speed, there is more pressure. So what happens, surrounding air from this surrounding air will push the ball towards this direction because the pressure here is more and the pressure here is less. It remains floating at one place. If you take this ball, you can see. Slightly more height. If you take this ball, it doesn't rise because of very heavy mass. If you take this ball, you can see that the ball goes to very large height but no stability. But if the same ball is taken here and if I make a slow speed, we can have a stability. You can see the ball is stable. And if I increase the speed, the ball is unstable. Now, if you guess this ball has some heavy particles here. So these heavy particles here make center of mass down and have more stability. It has more stability than other balls. But if I will keep this ball floating, and suppose I bring my hand here and I bring my hand down, see what happens. We observe that my hand, when I bring it down, it cannot touch the ball. It cannot touch the ball because the air which goes towards my hand will get reflected back and will make the pressure on the ball from the upper side also. So it will make air cushion between the ball and my hand. And that is why the ball remains suspended in the two pressures. It is sandwiched between the two pressures. It is a very interesting phenomenon. Now if I have the two balls, same mass, same volume, same size, same density, identical, and if I keep them floating, they will try to occupy same position. Because you have seen that the size, weight of the ball, that decides the position where it will be stable. But if the two balls try to occupy same position, see what happens. They keep on fighting for the same position and they try to push each other because their mass, volume and everything is same. It is very interesting to note this point. Now if I take a ball, say solid ball, here, now it is very heavy. It is not able to lift the ball at all. But if I take the two different balls, which are also solid, you can see this ball and this ball. This is slightly less in diameter. You can imagine that this is slightly bigger and is slightly smaller comparatively. So it is bigger ball. And if I ask it, if the diameter of this ball or radius of the ball is 10% more than this ball, 10%, then how much more is the area of cross section in percentage? The answer is 21%. Why 21? Because 10 square is 100 and 11 square is 121. So this ball has 21% more area of cross section. Now if I ask how much is the volume bigger than this by percentage. You can say that the answer is, yes, the answer will be 133.1%. Now, how I get 133.1 figure? Because 11 cube is 1331. And that is very interesting, that the volume of this is 133.1% more than this volume. And very simple mathematics. It is R square and R cube proportions. Now, if I keep this ball on this pipe and switch on, see what happens. I observe that the ball is not rising at all. But if I keep this ball and switch on, but if I keep this ball and switch on, the ball doesn't rise. Now you can argue that this is not able to rise, but is able to rise because area matters, area of cross section. The pressure is built up because of this bigger size. And when this ball goes to some height, air will escape out because of small diameter. Now if I take a filter and keep the ball in filter, I say the ball is stable, not falling down. But if I keep the filter like this and keep the ball, it will fall. It will roll down because of gravity. Now, I will show you a magic where the ball remains stable on the top. Okay, so we have seen that the ball remains stable here. But here, why it remains stable, the answer is different. My hand and this filter is supporting the weight of the ball and it is providing normal reaction. And that is why it is having equilibrium. In air, it is not able to attain steady state because it keeps on vibrating up and down, wobbling on the side. But with a support, it is stable. You can see it again. One more interesting feature is that if I keep the ball and switch on, it will go to some height. And if I switch off, see what happens. Surprisingly, the ball comes down slowly and has a smooth landing over the mouth of this pipe. Now, why the ball has smooth landing? Why it falls down slowly? The answer is very simple. The moment I make this motor off, the blades do not stop. They keep on rotating. So the air pressure doesn't fall suddenly to zero. It goes decreasing, goes on decreasing slowly. But if I keep the ball here and leave it, it comes down. It is called as free fall. Now what is free fall? It starts with zero velocity and the velocity goes on increasing. Why velocity increase? Because it has got acceleration. And why it is acceleration? Because of gravity. So the gravity will make acceleration and the ball will go on having more and more velocity and it is called as free fall. But here, when you switch off, observe, it is not free fall, it is controlled fall. It is slow fall. How? You can guess again. Even if you have a bigger size ball and keep it on this, it remains stable. And that is interesting. It is our Bernoulli principle. Thank you.